So, listen, I want to talk to you about... Do you still have a place in Switzerland?
I do.
Right. Yeah. Do you go there a lot?
Well, you know, my husband was very ill.
Yes,
and,
I know. That.
And recently, very sadly, passed away.
Yeah, so I heard. I was very sorry to hear that.
Yeah, thanks, Craig. And so I haven't been as much recently, but I was there just about a month ago, and to just... sort of rest up and get my head straight and all of that. It's beautiful. We've had a home there for about 41 years.
I rather fancy Switzerland.
Oh, you have every...
Didn't Chaplin go and live in Switzerland?
Yes,
Charlie Chaplin went to live in...
Yeah.
He had 8 kids after the age of 55, you know.
Did he?
Yeah.
Well, good.
That's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
I am. I'm going to have... I want to have like a dozen.
Well, you better get in shape, is all I can say.
I mean, get in shape. I'm sitting here. Yeah, I see your point. Yeah,
you know what? If you want to come and scout it out, I'm sure you've been, but...
I've never been to Switzerland. I've only ever seen cartoons with Goofy learning to ski.
Oh. Yeah. Well, come and visit, and I'll show you the most beautiful place in the world, and one of the most beautiful places in the world.
Well, what are you... are you doing it again?
I don't think you even know
you're doing it. You don't even know when you're doing it. You said come and see. So I'll show you one of the most beautiful.
No, I'm like, you just have a filthy mind.
Now this is the mind game you're playing with me. I do have a filthy mind. I admit I have a filthy mind.
So?
But you play mind games with my filthy mind.
I never.
You do. I can't even look at old, you know, DVDs of Mary Poppins without thinking, what the hell is going on there? What the hell is going on?
I have to tell you something about that.
What?
When I made Mary Poppins, I was married to my first husband, who was the designer of all the clothes of Mary Poppins.
Oh, designers were straight back then?
Yeah. This one was.
Oh, okay.
And that's my Emma's dad.
Oh, right.
Okay, got it?
Yeah.
And he decided that although Mary Poppins was extremely prim on the outside, if you looked at the petticoat or you looked at the lining of the jacket, they were always cherry red or crimson or bright blue. And he said, I think she has a little, tiny little sort of second life going on, you know?
Was this as you were getting together he had this idea?
No, this was when he was designing the clothes for me.
Yeah, yeah, but what I'm saying is, were you already married at this point?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. You were?
No,
right.
No, we were.
So he knew you pretty well then?
Well, he...
What I'm saying is he brought a little bit of his own experience of the actress and the creation of the part along with you, is what I'm saying.
Well, no, I think he actually just knew Mary, or thought he knew Mary Poppins very well.
I like Mary Poppins. Have you seen the one on Broadway?
Yes.
What do you think?
I have. Well, I saw it in London before it came to Broadway.
Right.
But I haven't seen the Broadway one. So
yeah, I saw it on Broadway. I went with my son. He was 7 at the time. And I thought, it was one of these moments where you get to know who your kid is. Because
yes.
I thought, you know, about just coming up to the interval, he said, I'm bored. Like, really loud.
Whoa.
And I thought, well, he's not gay. And that... That was all I ever thought about it, really.
But tell me, did he like the rest of the show?
Yeah, no, he loved it. Yeah,
did he?
No, I liked it too. I thought it was very nice.
Yeah, when you got to the chimney sweeps, it was okay.
I love a bit of chimney. You know, Dick Van Dyke was here recently.
Was he?
Yeah, he's coming back again.
He's just written a book.
That'll explain why he was just here.
He's a love, isn't he?
He's a lovely man,
yeah.
Isn't he? Yeah, no, he's very nice.
And unbelievably
tall.
Young, tall.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Wonderful.
He can still dance.
I know. The knees can still do, you know, knees up Mother Brown and all of that.
Knees up Mother Brown. And...
So you're going to come and look at Switzerland?
Yeah, yeah, I fancy it, actually. I mean, if I can get out of this dump, I'll be right there.
Yeah. Well, don't you get a
can
break?
Can I a week off or something, go to Switzerland, see Julie? What do you mean, no? They're trying to test me because I'm having a cuss-free week on the show. I'm trying not to cuss at all.
When do you begin?
I haven't... Oh, you mean with the rabbit?
Well, a little bit before that, too. No,
I don't think I think I give the impression of cussing even when I'm not. It's like the way you give the impression of... See, you're doing it again! You're doing it again! You give the impression, you might not be doing anything, but suddenly you just kind of... And you get to this... You get to this kind of smoulder, and I'm like, knock it off!
No, I'm just a good second banana, that's all.
No, I don't know if that's...
Yeah.
Is that code? We have to go. I'm getting very sleepy in my pajamas. Now, is there anything you'd care to plug before we go?
No. I mean, thank you for plugging this brand new book, which I'm so thrilled and pleased about.
Well, the book that's called The Very Fairy Princess Takes the Stage is number one
right.
on the
children's bestseller list. And, there's a third one coming out next year.
Well, you could plug that a bit.
Fourth one after that. Yeah. I could.
Yeah. Ooh, mouth organ or awkward pause?
Well, I don't play them. Well, which would you rather? Said she.
I'll just fetch it. I'll be right back.
Oh, he knew what he wanted.
He knows what he wants. You're... Right, here you are.
All right, what do I have to do?
Just blow it. You know, fine.
Hold on. Is there anything in here?
See? No, don't say
anyway,
it like that.
No.
Now,
sorry.
Unwrap it. Slower.
Now, tell me if... You have to hold it.
You are so naughty.
You know what? That's a cop-out, isn't it, gang?
What?
Yeah, it really is.
What's a cop-out?
You just get away with murder and you say, oh, you're so naughty, you know? Wait a minute.
You've
which
seen
side
through
do I
my
play this?
Technique.
Yeah, which side? This side?
I don't know. Which side do you think you should blow for?
Will you shut up? Oh! Gave you a nasty shock, doesn't it? Yeah.
Ready? One, two, three, four. Welcome, neighborhood dogs. We didn't get to the emails tonight because Julie Andrews was here. So I thought what we could do is very briefly, I could briefly do the emails before I went to bed. Before I climbed the stairs to Noddington Junction. Took the sleepy train to Bedfordshire. Nothing like a 49-year-old man pretending to be an infant in a basement to make you feel a little creepy. What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
Ooh, I smell tweet mails and eggs.
All right, I won't bother with the jingle, it's too late. This is from Tammy in South Carolina, who says, hello, Craig, and Jeff.
Goodie.
My 16-year-old wants to change her first name. What do you think? Should I make her wait until she's 18? Yeah, go ahead, restrict her, that'll work. This is from Stephanie in Pickerton, Ohio. She says, dear Craig, Pickerington in Ohio says, dear Craig, I just got out of a 5-year relationship. I'd like to start dating again, but I'm the worst flit in the world. How do I approach guys? Wear something low cut. This is from Luke. We're not complicated. This is from Luke in Perth Amboy, New Jersey. Dear Craig and Jeff and stuff. I have a buddy who's trying so hard to get women to like him. He's jealous because women flock to me. What could I do for him? Get over yourself. This is from Blanca in Mexico City, Mexico, who says, hi, Craig. I'm originally from the United States, but my parents forced me to move to Mexico. I want to move back, but I don't know if I should. What should I do? I don't know. This is from James in Reading, Pennsylvania, who says, hi, Craig, I am going to meet my fiancé's parents for the first time, and I want to make a good impression. Any advice? Yes, make a pass at her dad. This is from... women love that. This is from Corey in Dallas, Texas, who says, "Dear Craig, I want to ask my boss for a raise, but I don't know how to go about I want to ask my boss for a raise, but I don't know how to go about doing it. Any suggestions? How about, may I have a raise?" This is from Bruce in Boston, Massachusetts, who says, "Dear Craig, my wife bought season tickets to the opera, and after several shows, I don't think I can take it anymore." Any advice on telling her how to go it alone? Yeah, look at me. Look at me. This is a guy who knows how to say no to a woman. Look at me. Do what you're told. Wear the princess fairy pajamas or pay the consequences. That's all I'm saying. All right, I know we're out of time. I'll just finish it off, though. This is from Vivian in Litchfield, Connecticut, who says, "Hey, Craig, when you throw an unread tweet mail off your desk, do you ever wish you had read it and answered it?"